Yesterday did not go very well at all. I ended up, having a 3-minute talk with my husband. By the time it got to my turn, we went way over 3 minutes. Really wasn't that emotional to talk about, but I told him everything I was feeling. I told him how unfair I felt everything was. I told him about his mom calling me lazy again and how much weight that holds on my heart. We got sidetracked talking about all my stuff in the scrapbooking room in my craft room. My bins of stuff. He just kept trying to prove his point. He didn't want to listen to me. I go to bed exhausted and tired and I fall asleep and I wake up this morning and he's no different. No loving, no nice words, no nothing. Just like last night. He gets in the shower. I thought about joining him, and when I walked in, he was jerking off. No big deal, right? Immediately, he notices me, and he stops, and he bends over so I can't see anything. And I open up the shower door, and I say, "Can I join you?" And instead of him saying, "Yeah, please do," or anything, he's just like, "You can, but I'm almost done." Or, "I'm almost done, but you can." So, whatever. Finish up. I'm gonna go lay down. Doesn't matter. And of course, I caught him red-handed, right? Red-fisted, whatever you wanna call it. And just like every other time I've caught him, he tries pretending that I didn't see what I saw. He comes into the bedroom and I'm pouting and I'm sulking and I'm feeling sorry for myself because he's rejecting me. And instead of him making me feel better, he keeps denying it. I tell him it would be better for me if he'd admit it because, just like deleting the picture yesterday, it drove me crazy trying to convince myself that he's right and I'm wrong. All day today, it's going to drive me crazy that he's right and I'm wrong. Even though I know what I saw, he knows what he did, but yet he doesn't want to admit that he was wrong. And instead of him, I even told him, I said, "I don't have a problem with what you're doing, I have a problem that you're lying about it." Instead of making me feel better, he starts kissing me, pushes me on the bed, and he fucks me. And I'm crying the whole time. He basically rapes me. I didn't want that. Not after he's lying to me, not after whatever. But do I say anything? Do I say stop? Do I say get up? Do I say anything? No. Because then that will just turn into a fight. And I don't want to fight. I just want to feel better. So, after he's done, which was like no time at all, wonder why. He's like, "Is that why?" Is that what you thought I was doing in the shower? I'm like, it doesn't matter what I think. If you ain't ready to fess up to it, it doesn't matter what I think. You weren't gonna come clean because you don't want to come clean. You weren't gonna give me that one moment of being right. I mean, you are incapable. He is incapable of letting me have one on him. It's like he's scared of it, I guess, right? I get that. I'm scared of him all the time. He's scared of the fight. He's scared of the guilt trip. He's scared of me using it against him or whatever. So he will do everything in his power to admit that he didn't do it. So I get in the shower and I just start sobbing uncontrollably. He comes in the bathroom. He says he's leaving. And I basically tell him, I said, when I lied about your tablet, not looking at your tablet, I understood why I lied. I lied because I was scared of you. I lied that I was scared to tell you the truth. I lied about because I didn't want the argument. So I understand why you're lying now. But just like yesterday, a photo that you assumed I deleted, that I know I didn't, put me into a state of despair. I don't know what this is going to do for me because you obviously can't fess up to it. You are incapable of letting me have my truth. It's across the board, not just this one situation. He says I'm staring at a guy. I say I'm not. He's incapable of letting me have my truth. He has to convince me for hours and hours and hours that his version of events is more correct than mine, and mine must be crazy. Constantly gaslighting me. Constantly. I catch him doing something wrong, and instead of me getting the, yeah, you're right, hon, I'm sorry, or anything. You're right, yeah, what are you going to do about it? Anything, any kind of response would have been better than denying it. I tell him, I said, congratulations. Whether you convinced me today that you're right, that you didn't do it, or you convinced me that I agree with you for lying. Either way, you've convinced me. Either way, my my version of events doesn't matter. I understand where you're coming from on both accounts. And that, he doesn't say nothing. He doesn't respond. He just says, I gotta go to work. I gotta get there early. Okay, have a good day at work, honey. And he leaves, and instead of me crying uncontrollably like I was just a few minutes before then, now I'm pissed. I don't feel despair. I feel anger. I feel resentment. I feel bitterness. And this anger, resentment, and bitterness feels so much better than feeling hopeless and despair and crazy. I don't know why I'm recording this right now. I mean, I could have waited till I got to my car, but I needed to process this right now. I needed to get rid of it. Because I was feeling despair less than half an hour ago, and now I'm feeling better. And now that I've talked it out loud, I feel better, and I can get in the car and think about other things and enjoy my kids when I take them to school. And fuck him. Fuck him and his damn hypocritical double standard bullshit. Can't keep living like this.